Good morning, one and all. I am K. Sunita, Assistant Professor, Mechanical Department. Today I am going to give a presentation on Introduction to CAD/CAM. As yesterday we have discussed about what is CAD and what is CAM. Let's take a brief discussion on this. CAD/CAM is a term in which computer-aided design and computer-aided manufacturing, and it is the technology concerned with digital computers to perform certain functions in design and manufacturing. And what is CAD? CAD is computer-aided design, which can be defined as the use of computer system to assist in the creation, modification, analysis and optimization of the design. And computer-aided manufacturing, it is defined as the use of computer systems to plan, manage, control various operations in the manufacturing plant. And this CAM is mainly categorized into two different types. One is computer monitoring control and computer manufacturing support applications. What is computer monitoring and control? Here in this CAM application, we are using computers where the computers not only monitor but also control the program and functions of the manufacturing process. And coming to manufacturing support applications, here it is known as indirect application of computers, where computers are only used for planning, scheduling of the production process, but it is not directly related to the manufacturing process. Such type of use of computers in manufacturing is known as manufacturing support applications, and it is also known as indirect application of computers. And the computers are used mainly in production in various processes like numerical control part programming, and also computer automated process planning, and also computers are used in to generate work standards, and also computers are used in production scheduling, and also material requirements planning and shop floor control. Now let us understand in detail what is CIM. CIM means Computer Integrated Manufacturing. If you see, this is the abbreviation which we use for Computer Integrated Manufacturing, and it is a system in which all the functions of CAD and CAM are combined or integrated together, and it is known as CIM. Here we use computers for automated material handling, and also we use industrial robots in the manufacturing plant. In addition, the computers are also used for business applications like managerial administrative methodologies like CRM, ERP, MRP, TQM, etc. Coming to fundamentals of CAD, computer-aided design, as we have learned, it involves in various activities of the design, like to develop, analyze, modify and optimize an engineering design. And also it is also known as ICG. The computers, the CAD system which we use in design, it is called as ICG, which means interactive computer graphics, where designer and computer and the designer will combinedly perform the task to develop a design. And ICG, we can call it as, it is an interactive computer graphics where we are using computers, and this computer consists of hardware and software. This is the configuration of the computer system which we use in the CAD system. And the hardware, as we all know, the hardware includes central processing unit, one or more workstations, and also some peripheral devices like printers, plotters and other drafting equipments. And software consists of computer programs to implement graphics processing, which means we are used some computers like CAD, AutoCAD, ProE, Ansys, CATIA softwares we use, and we will develop a design in the by using computer. And we can develop geometric elements, basic geometric elements like points, lines, circles, etc. Workstation in the computer. What is workstation? Workstation is not only one computer we use in the design process. Simply a computer, it is not called as a workstation. Then what is the workstation? Workstation consists of all the peripheral devices, graphic display, and all the drafting equipment combinedly and collectively. We call it as a workstation in the CAD system. In general, a CAD system consists of workstations and also graphic terminals and also input devices like electronic tablet and pen. And why we implement CAD? Why we are implementing CAD in design process? Because it will increase the productivity of the designer, and also it will improve the quality of the designer, and also it improves communications. Why we are calling it is improving communications means when we design a drawing by using computer, that will be very much legible and clear when compared to manual drawings. And whatever the designer wants to convey the message to other person, it will be conveyed very clearly without any there will be no miscommunications and no errors while understanding the drawing. And also it will have a major important thing is it will have a database where we can store all the drawings which we are making in the computer. We can store in the database, which can be remodified, and we can also take the printouts, and also we can transfer the data to the manufacturing process. Now coming to design process. Now let us understand in detail what is CAD, computer aided design. In computer aided design, if any person want to create something new, then he has to follow this design process. This design process has been introduced by the scientist called Shigley, which consists of 6 steps, which is also known as iterative process. It consists of, first one is recognition of need, definition of problem, synthesis, analysis and optimization, evaluation and presentation. Now what is recognition of need? Why we are developing that product? What is the need, basic need to develop that component? That is the recognition of the need. And also next step is we need to define the problem. What is the problem involved in the existing one? If the component is already in the market and we want to implement something new to the component, we want to develop the component, we want to improve the quality of the product, then we need to define the problem of the existing one. And also synthesis. What is synthesis? Synthesis is to develop the designs, to develop the drawings by using software. And analysis. After developing the designs, we need to perform analysis. By using some softwares, we will analyze, like FEA, we will perform some test on the design and we will get to know whether the product is able to withstand all the given loads. And evaluation, there they will evaluate whether the component or the design is satisfying the given specifications or not. They will do evaluation, and finally they will give the presentation where the documentation will be carried out and we will take the printouts of the particular design. These are all the 6 steps which are known as design process, which is known as iterative process. Now look at this. This is a block diagram. Whatever we have learned, we can see here. First, recognition of the need, and then after recognizing the need of the why we are developing, then they will define the problem of the component, then they will do the synthesis and they will do the analysis and then they will do evaluation. Now if you see analysis and optimization and synthesis, there is some arrow going above the synthesis. What is this? This is the iterative process where if after design is being made and when they perform some analysis, and if in the analysis if something goes wrong, then they will again perform the design process. So this process is known as, that is why it is known as iterative process. Repeat, they will repeat some steps in the design process, so it is known as iterative process. Now in this we can understand how computer is being used in this design process. Now coming after defining the problem, from here we use computers. By using some software, we will develop the drawings. In synthesis, we perform geometric modeling, where we will design or develop the drawing by using computers. In geometric modeling, we will do the designs, and we will also perform in the second step, analysis and optimization. We will perform by using some software, we will perform the analysis, and after that, we will do the design review and evaluation. Whether the design and the analysis are meeting the given specifications or not, we will check, and then they will do the automated drafting is done, which means we will take the printouts or we will store the design in the database. That is known as presentation of the design. Now coming to geometric modeling, we all know what is geometric modeling. Geometric modeling is nothing but it is the mathematical description of the component, which we do by using computers. We will design one, we will develop one drawing. By using computers, we are developing one drawing, and the computers will give us the detailed description of the mathematical description of the component, where we can modify and redo the design. That is why it is known as geometric modeling, because we are giving mathematical description of the geometry of an object is given. That is why it is known as geometric modeling. We are drawing as per the given dimensions. We are developing the design in the computer. And mathematical description allows the image of the object to be displayed. When the object is displayed on the graphic terminal, it will also give us the dimensions. We can see the dimensions. And by using some hardware components like CPU, by receiving the signals from CPU of the CAD system, it will perform all this activity. So software and hardware combinedly we use in the computer to develop the drawings. And in geometric modeling, we can develop the drawing in three different types. In the three different types, we can make the drawing in geometric modeling by using a computer. We can develop two-dimensional drawings, where two-dimensional like flat objects we can also draw by using computers. We can develop two-dimensional drawings, and also we can develop the second one, two-and-a-half-dimensional objects. What is two-and-a-half-dimensional objects? Two-and-a-half-dimensional objects are nothing but where the length and the width are, we can see, and also there will be some thickness which is negligible. Where the thickness is negligible, those type of objects are known as 2.5-dimensional objects. For example, we can take tin smithy objects. Okay, the tin smithy objects, if you take the sheet of the metal sheet of the which we use to make a rectangular tray, the thickness is very less. Those type of objects we call it as 2.5-dimensional objects. And also we can develop 3-dimensional objects, where length, width and breadth of an object, height of an object can be seen. Next one, after geometric modeling, they will perform engineering analysis will be carried out in CAD system. What is engineering analysis? Why we make this engineering analysis? If we do not perform the analysis on the given design, it may fail at the end. So it is a very important part in the geometric, in the design process, where we have to do some modeling, analysis on the given model. Thank you. Let us continue in the next class.